Today's topic is HTML and CSS. What is HTML? HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. It is not a programming language. This language is used to describe the structure of web page. It consists of tags and data, that is information enclosed by opening tag and closing tag. It is case sensitive. This is the HTML syntax. HTML opening tag and this is with slash HTML, this is the closing tag. It has two sections, one is head and another is body. Head section contains extra information about the page, that is title, script, style and link. This is the body section, which contains the actual design. This is the header tag, H1. This is HR tag, this is image tag, this is input tag, which is of type text. HR tag is kind of single line tag. Image tag, which we use to display an image on our web page with this src attribute, src, alt and class, these are the attributes. Let's move toward the CSS. It stands for cascading style sheet style. CSS used to style an element HTML document, that is it describes how HTML element should be displayed. CSS saves a lot of work. It can control a layout of multiple web pages all at once. Element selector, class selector, ID selector. On these selectors, you can apply a CSS style. These are the ways to write a CSS. Inline CSS. It uses a style attribute of their tag. This is the P tag and this is the style attribute of that tag. These are the properties and value. This is internal CSS, uses a style tag in a head section. This is the style tag which we use in a head section and this is the syntax, how you can write a CSS inside that style tag. P is the selector of type element. This is the property and value. External CSS, which is written outside the page with .css extension file. This is the link which we use to attach that external CSS file to our HTML page. Next, we will see one demo of HTML CSS on VS Code and Chrome browser.
This is our demo.html file. This is the HTML opening tag. This is HTML closing tag. This is the head section with title tag. This is the body section. You can see some header tags over here like h1 and h2. There are total 6 header tags from h1 to h6. This is image tag to show a image file into our web page. This is the P tag, that is for paragraph. This is the content inside that P tag. This is the br element to break the line. This is the strong tag to show a content in a bold format. This is the input tag of type text, which will accept the input from user from our browser. These are some attributes of it like type, name, ID, class, value and placeholder. Let's add one div into our HTML page. This is the div and Sunbeam Pune in div1, this is the content. This is the class attribute and this is the name of that class. This is style attribute which we are using it for inline CSS properties. This is the background color aqua, height is a CSS property and 50 pixel is the value of it. Let's add one more div into our code. This is the second div with class name mydiv_2 and the content is Sunbeam Karad in div2. Let's add internal CSS property for this div. By using style tag, we can able to add CSS properties for that class. This is the class name. These are the CSS properties and values for it. Okay, on web page, you can able to see the divs are appeared here and the CSS properties are applied to that div. Let's add one more CSS property to our image file. S1 is a class name, and we already written my style.css file. Inside that CSS file, we have used a class selector S1 and applied a CSS properties for it. To apply external CSS properties to our code, we have to add a link tag like this way, and we have to mention that file name. It will apply a CSS accordingly. Thank you.